Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. Back on my series on my bachelor's paper. And we are going to dive right in. Today, you are going to learn about the first algebraic structure ever, the most simplest one, called the magma or groupoid. Whatsoever, I'm going to refer to it as a magma. What exactly is a magma? Well, at first, I would like to take a look at a non-empty set. It can possibly also be empty, but we are going to go by the standards. Let's consider a non-empty set, M. Okay. And also we want to consider a binary operation on this M right here, on the set M. And we are going to refer to it as this composition right here, this little circle. So we are going to take a look at a little pair right here. You might ask yourself, what the hell is a binary operation? Well, it just means we are going to take two elements out of this set right here, use the operation on it, and it's going to map those two elements with the operation onto a single element of M. Meaning, in mathematical terms, we are going to define this composition right here, this circle, as just the Cartesian product of M with itself being mapped to a single element of M. You can also put it that way. We are going to take a pair, AB, out of M cross M, and we are going to map it to circle of A and B, meaning this right here is nothing but A in composition with B. Some people, for simplification purposes, like to refer to this as just the product of A with B, without this circle in it. If it's clear from the context what we are talking about, we are just going to use this notation right here because it's easy. Once we are going to talk about homomorphisms, we are going to make a difference right here. Not writing this, we are going to write it like this, because sometimes you have to deal with two binary operations. Okay, now what the hell is a magma? Well, we're going to call this pair right here a magma, this exact pair. So this set and this binary operation is exactly a magma, if and only if, for all A and B out of this M, we have that A in composition with B is once again element of M. This is what we call closure under this operation. So if M, the set, is closed under the operation, then we are going to refer to this as a magma, the simplest algebraic structure you could possibly think about. And in next step, we are going to prove that the natural numbers form a magma under addition. Under addition, yes. So before getting really started, remember what it means for something to be magma. Well, what we want to show is that the natural numbers are closed under addition. Meaning, if we define a certain proposition, P of n, we want to show that for all n element of natural numbers, we have that m plus n is once again element of natural numbers. That's just the basic definition of closure under addition on natural numbers. And we want this m to be a fixed but arbitrary natural number. It doesn't depend on m. N is our variable we are going to do induction on. So starting off with the base step, P of 0. Well, what do we have then? Well, plugging in the 0 into this n, we have m plus 0. Well, by the first rule of addition, this is nothing but m. And, well, we have chosen m to be a fixed but arbitrary natural number, so this does hold. Okay, coolio. Next, we are going to define our induction hypothesis. Well, we are going to assume that P of k, meaning that m plus k, this element of natural numbers, is true. Okay, so just basic induction, we have done this before. And now we want to show that this ensures P of successor of k to be true. So, what happens to P of successor of k? Well, what is that exactly? This is nothing but m plus suck of k. This formula fucking sucks. And by the second rule of addition, we can drag the successor to the front, you could say. So we have the successor of m plus k. And by our induction hypothesis, we know that m plus k is exactly element of natural numbers. Why not say that m plus k, by our p of k, is nothing but, let's say, s, for example. So that means we have the successor of s. And by our second Peano axiom, we also know whenever some element s is element of natural numbers, that also means that this thing has a unique successor of s, also element of natural numbers. So by our Peano axioms, we also know that this thing is element of natural numbers, and then we are done. I thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, then please like and subscribe, recommend the channel if you like, share this video. And yeah, well, you can also support the channel by buying those t-shirts I created, support the channel on Patreon. If you don't want any of that, just basically, yeah, watch my videos. That already helps a lot. Sharing is caring, activate the bell button, and up until the next video, have a, what the fuck is this abomination? Have a chameleon day. See ya.
Der wurde auch mit vier Katzen zusammen ausgesetzt.
Stimmt, ja.